Hey, my name is Chris, and I represent the network layer of the OSI model. Overall, Layer 3 is responsible for routing packets from one node to another between networks. Primary jobs of the network layer include logical addressing, routing, encapsulation, fragmentation, reassembly, and error handling. The first thing we're going to talk about is logical addressing. Each node that wants to send or receive information outside of their network must have a logical address. The protocol we use to achieve this is either IP version 4 or IP version 6. Addresses are assigned either statically or dynamically via a DHCP server. Statically assigned machines generally include devices like servers and printers, whereas dynamically assigned machines are for host machines. In addition, Layer 3 uses the logical IP addresses, which you can change at will, whereas Layer 2 uses MAC addresses, which are burned in the NIC and you theoretically cannot change. The current most used protocol today is IP version 4. IP version 4 addresses are 32 bits in size and broken up into 4 octets or groups of 8 bits. IP version 4 addresses use dotted decimal notation for humans to read, but it also has a binary equivalent, which is how the computer reads the address. In addition, there are up to 2 to the 32nd or 4.19 billion addresses available. One of the problems with IP version 4 is running out of them. Enter IP version 6. IP version 6 addresses are 128 bits in size, and they consist of 8 groups of 4 hexadecimal digits separated by colons. There are up to 2 to 128, or 3.4 times 10 to 38 addresses available. That is, by today's standards, 4.8 times 10 to the 28th addresses per person, whereas IP version 4 provides less than 1 address per person. Next, we will talk about routing and encapsulation. The router takes the information from the Layer 4 PDU or Transport Layer PDU and adds or appends the Layer 3 header. It then sends the packet to the Layer 2 or Data Link layer. This process is called data encapsulation and provides the necessary information for the network layer. The Layer 3 header includes many fields, but the most important are the source and destination IP addresses. That way, it knows what host it came from and where it is going. In addition to encapsulating, the network layer must be able to direct or route the information. Sometimes the source and destination hosts are not on the same network. The device routing the information finds the best paths to take based on different things. The paths between networks are called hops, and the router determines which hops will provide the most efficient way to travel between networks based on quality of service, cost, and network congestion, to name a few. The network layer's main responsibility is to deliver data between networks. After encapsulation, data is passed to the data link layer. The problem is, sometimes the message being sent is too large for the maximum frame size at layer 2. If this happens, the network layer will divide the message into multiple fragments that are sent individually and reassembled on arrival of the destination network layer, aka fragmentation and reassembly. For an Ethernet frame, the maximum payload size is generally 1500 bytes. As shown in the image, we have a message that is 4,464 bytes. The Layer 3 device splits, or fragments, it into 4 separate units, which will be sent at 1500 bytes or less each. When it reaches the destination Layer 3 device, it will then be reassembled to the full 4,464 bytes. Finally, there is error handling. The Internet Control Message Protocol, or ICMP, is used between operating systems of network computers to send error messages. It is a unique protocol because it operates at the network layer and isn't used to exchange data. It is merely used to provide feedback and is not always reliable. ICMP is used by the popular diagnostic tools ping and traceroute.